So this is how you make mashed potatoes. And that is how you make mashed potatoes.
Look at all this nice mashed potatoes, ready to eat.
Hello my friends, how are you doing today? Today I'm gonna review the Glock 30S. It is a compact 45 ACP that is double stacked, holds 10 rounds. So this slide right here is actually 1/12 of an inch thinner than the Glock 30 Gen 4. So that's why it has the S designation for slim. So the first thing that I like about this Glock is its size. As you can tell, I can easily put it in my pocket and this clip holds it up high so I don't have to go digging for it. It's easy to carry around anywhere I want. It's not too heavy, really concealable. I just put it in my pocket, throw my shirt over, and nobody knows it's there. The second thing I like about this pistol is that it is chambered in 45 ACP, which many experts consider to be the absolute best self-defense round in terms of stopping the threat when the threat is another human. I wouldn't want to have to rely on this to stop a grizzly bear. I don't think it would work. The third thing I like about this pistol is, considering its size and the size of the 45 ACP, it holds a lot of rounds. It holds 10 rounds. 10 rounds should be adequate in most self-defense situations. The fourth thing I like about this pistol is it's incredibly reliable. As long as I keep it oiled a little bit, and this thing just works. So, extremely reliable. The fifth thing I like about this pistol is that it's very easy to use. It has several safety mechanisms, all but one are internal. The only external one is right here on the trigger. Everything else is internal, and so it won't accidentally shoot whether you drop it or whatever. In order for this to shoot, you have to pull the trigger. I love simplicity, and Glock makes their guns extremely simple, and that's one reason why they're so popular. Now, those are the five things I like about the Glock 30S. I'm going to tell you the five things I don't like about this pistol. So, the first thing I don't like about this pistol is I wish the grip was a little bit longer. So, as you can see, my pinky isn't all the way on the gun. It's hanging off. It'd be nice if it was just half an inch longer, then my pinky would be all the way on the gun. I'd have a nice solid full grip on the gun. The second thing I don't like about this pistol, the recoil is noticeably more than a larger frame 45 caliber. There's less weight to dampen the kick of that projectile as it leaves the gun. And so you feel that kick and it just takes a little bit longer to reacquire your target. Not a huge deal, not a deal breaker. But it's something that you need to be aware of if you're considering purchasing this gun. So the third thing I don't like about this pistol, the trigger's not that smooth and I wish it had a cleaner break. When you shoot this gun versus a 1911, you can tell a huge difference. And I wish these triggers were more like the 1911 triggers. Nice and crisp. So the fourth thing I don't like about this pistol, and I'm a little bit embarrassed to say, I don't know if it's just me, the Glock 30S, or just this specific pistol, I cannot for the life of me get this slide off. I know how to take off Glock slides. I've got many Glock slides. I don't feel like I should have to research how to take off the slide of a Glock. They should be the same across the board. I know it has the same thing that you pull down. You can take out the magazine, pull the slide back a little bit, pull it, push this down, and push forward. But that didn't work. So what if it's cocked? Let's try that. Still no. So let's try further back. Still no. I don't know. It's not working. So that's the fourth thing I don't like about this pistol. The fifth thing I don't like about this pistol is it doesn't seem to be very accurate. When it's a small distance between the front sight and the rear sight, it's not very accurate, and that's what you have here. So those are the five things I don't like about this gun. Now let's go shoot it. So the targets are about 50 feet away. Let's see how accurate we can be with this Glock 30S. I forgot how much kick.
We did it! 50 feet away with a 3.5-inch barrel. I don't think that's too bad. Okay, we've got some more targets set up. We're gonna go ahead and shoot them and see how well we do. Yeah, we got them all again, including, we got 3 targets with 1 bullet. Did you see that? That's insane. So I'm gonna show you how to shoot accurately, because with a gun this small, it's really hard to shoot accurately. This is the key. Takes a lot of practice, but you can do it. So there's no bullets in here right now. So a lot of times when you shoot the gun, you pull the trigger and then you jerk it and you point down trying to compensate. So the correct thing to do is slowly apply more and more pressure on the trigger, keeping your target on sight, not flinching away, slowly applying more pressure until it shoots, and you let it surprise you. Don't try to anticipate it, just let it shock you, let it surprise you. And it takes some practice doing, but you get a few hundred rounds through your pistol and you make sure you always keep your eyes on the target. You make sure you slowly increase the pressure on the trigger and don't anticipate. Don't do this. You may not even notice you're doing it, but if you're not hitting anything on target, you're probably doing it. Just let it surprise you, and then you'll get it, okay? You know, 50 feet away hitting these small targets, that takes some practice. A brand new person typically can't do that. You gotta practice, and incorporate what I just told you into your practice. You'll be able to get pretty good. Okay, we're gonna shoot one more set of targets. Let's do it. And we did it again. So I really like shooting this little guy. I love that I can take this with me anywhere. I don't need a holster. The clip, put it in my pocket. Clip keeps it up high enough so where I can grab it quickly if I need it. It's a great gun. And it's fairly accurate. I like shooting it. I do. I really love shooting it. Hey, thanks for coming to my channel and watching this video. I upload videos every week. I try to give you the very best content. If you liked this video, please click that like button. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe so I can make better content for you. Thank you very much, and come again next week. You have a wonderful day.